Hi, I'm Ben Fisk from Angling Times. This is one of the most stunning venues we've ever visited. Just take a look at this scenery around here. It's Coombs Reservoir and it's just north of Buxton, which is right in the middle of the Derbyshire Peak District. And what's even better, it's full of fish. Now this is Dynamite Baits and Fox Match's Gareth Drury. And over there we've got Andy Bennett of Fox Match and Bait Tech. He's the current Matchman of the Year. And they're both catching loads and loads of fish for us today. Let's go see how they're doing it. Gareth.
Hi Ben.
What a spectacular venue this is then. You could be fishing in Ireland.
Absolutely brilliant. It's free fishing, you've got a backdrop like that, nobody else fishing whatsoever, and there's loads of bites.
Is it just a case of a single feeder rod? Is that all you need here to catch?
That's all you need. Simple setup. Single baits, biggish hooks, simple feeder tactics.
Yeah, so it's Your basic paternoster rig.
Yeah, 15 pound braid or 14 or Klemph, and it swings like an helicopter.
Yeah.
Anti-tangle.
Do you need braid here or?
Not really, no. Braid just gives you better bite detection, but normal standard mono just work just the same. Just my rod's a little bit heavier than most and it just shows bites up.
Yeah, okay. What's this here?
That's my ground bait, simple ground bait, nothing in, bit of corn, Silver X ground bait.
Yeah.
Just plug it.
Plug it quite tight?
Yeah, fairly tight, chuck it out.
It is quite quite deep out there. You've got a shallow bit and then it drops off, I take it, and that's where you're casting to get to those.
Just get it over, find about 8 foot. Most reservoirs are fairly deep anyway. Just get off that drop off where fish feel safe and you'll get some bites.
Right, if you can cast that out for us, Gareth, and see if you can catch another skimmer bream from the reservoir here. This is Gareth's way of fishing this with the paternoster and a reasonably long hook length and a single dead red maggot on the single hook length. We've got a very different approach on the next peg that Andy's using. Let's go and see what he's doing. Now, Andy, you've been fishing here all your life, I take it?
Yeah, I've been coming since probably 8 years old when my dad used to bring me one as a kid and that, and we've just started to come back on recently, the last couple of years.
So. Yeah, what do you like about it?
It's just, well, for a start it's free fishing, which is a bonus, and then you don't get any miver, there's no one bothering you, anything like that. The fishing's starting to pick up again now, there's loads of skimmers and roach showing,
yeah.
So it's just starting to fish really well.
You catch a few on the pole as well, you told me.
Yeah, when the... Normally, back end of the year, probably August, September time is best time for it. At the moment, there's not a great deal of roach on the pole, but mainly all feeder fishing. But once they've finished spawning and everything, they move into the middle of the lake and stuff, it can be, you know, you can catch 30-pound bags of roach.
Yeah. Is this the best spot on here, the middle of the lake?
Normally the middle of the lake, because there's a deepish bowl. The two little bays are normally the shallow bit, and then there's a shallow, that's a shallow end. The dam head can be quite deep in places. But generally, this is what they call the bridge field. From this point down here to my left sort of thing, and opposite, is probably a good 10 foot on the feeder line, and you'll get like 6 to 8 foot on the pole line here.
Yeah. Let's just take a look at this this setup here, Andy. It's caught my eye immediately.
Yeah.
It's the traditional Northwest 2-hook rig, which is only allowed in this region. Although we're not technically northwest here in Derbyshire, it is allowed on this particular venue. What's the idea behind this, Andy, and how have you got it set up?
Well, basically, I've just got a fixed feeder there, and I'll have a swivel. Then on my swivel, I'll have 4 foot of old 12, which is your normal hook length. And then just like, say, a third of the way down the hook length, I'll have a old 14, so it's slightly stiffer. You know, it keeps the line away from the actual hook length, and you just have an inch or two, and it just acts as a double hook. You know, you've got two hooks then, and you can try different baits. I've got single on that and double on that. I'll switch them about, and you can put a bigger bait on that.
Which hook do the fish come on most?
When they're finicky, you tend to catch them on the longer tail, but when they're actually on the feed, I mean, you do get double hookups as well. I've had a couple of double hookups today. When they're actually on the feed, you tend to catch most of your fish on that. I'd probably say 70% of your fish will come on the bottom hook, and then, you know, 1 in 5 fish might come on your top hook, something like that. So.
Right. These are the kind of setups you need here at Coombs, the baits. Andy's got Bait Tech Omen ground bait here for his feeder with a few pellets in. So that's the setups you need. Just sit back and enjoy this bit of footage we filmed for you of the lads in action here. Well, what a day it's been here, right in the heart of the Peak District. If you're visiting here, don't forget to pack those rods, because anybody can come here, fish for free, catch a load of skimmer bream on simple feeder tactics like Andy and Gareth over there have shown us today. Very easy, very cheap, and you'll catch a load of fish to boot. Thanks for watching us. I'm Ben Fisk, and I'll see you next time, hopefully on the bank.